Hi, my name is Adrianne, and I'm a Melbourne-based illustrator and motion designer. One of my most frequently asked questions is, what tools and softwares do I use for my creative process? Today, I'll be showing you how I use Adobe Illustrator and After Effects to create illustration and animation, such as this artwork of mine. It's one of my most popular projects to date, and I just really love the color palette. If you've been illustrating your whole life, you may find that animation can be a bit daunting. But I'll show you how simple and easy it is to use After Effects to add life and animation to your work. So let's get into it. So I've prepared the illustration in Adobe Illustrator. I used pen tool and my mouse to create the illustrations here. I just really like how I get a lot of control with the curve and I get this really minimalist and clean look. And for this project, I separated them into two files. So there's the character and the background files, and I put them in layers and name each of the elements that I want to animate in After Effects. Once you have them imported, they will appear in this project window where you have all your files, your audio, and your assets that you're going to be working with. So it's kind of like your library. In the timeline, you will also be working with your effects and keyframing, and this is your preview window where you see all the action. So the first effect that I want to share with you guys is this swaying leaf over here. Some people have asked me how I did this effect, and it's really simple. If you go to the effects and preset panel, and you just type CC Bandit, and you just drag that effect onto the layer that you want to have that effect on. And when I go to this effect control panel, you adjust the band slider and look at how naturally it's bending. It's really that simple. Another thing that I've put onto this layer is this expression LoopOut. So instead of copy and pasting all the keyframes to keep it animating, when I option click on this clock icon, you'll see that I use this LoopOut expression. So this will allow the keyframes to keep animating until the timeline ends. Another effect that I use for this animation is the wave effect, and similarly to Bandit, I just dragged it onto the layer that I want to have it on, and there's just so many different things like the blur, lighting, distortion, color correction, and what's really cool about it, you can overlay the different effects on top of one another so you can get this really cool look that you never knew existed before. It's definitely worth your time to explore and experiment with it. Another really cool thing about working in Adobe Illustrator and After Effects is how easy it is to update your file. So I have this background file over here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a copy of the same file, and then I'll change the colors into this night version. So all the layers and the name, they're all the same. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to save this and overwrite the old file that is being used in After Effects. So that's the file that we are using in After Effects. And we'll save that and replace it. And I'm going to move back to After Effects. And it's just processing the change. And yep, now it's all updated. All the keyframes and animation and all the effects that you have put into all the different composition will stay the same. So this is a really easy way to change and update your project file without having to re-import everything. And it's really integrated, and it's just really seamless experience to use between the different products. And this is the whole new version of the sunset animation in a different color. So I also changed, I did some color correction to the character so I didn't have to create a new one to suit the new environment. So that's it for today. I hope you guys find it useful to start exploring After Effects and Illustrator for your own creative projects. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you guys again.